We're in the parking lot of the gas station right now. It's about 6:30 in the morning, and we are on the way to go hit legs. But I'm here at the gas station because I had to stop and pick up some caffeine. This is the rain, tropical storm. So I got about probably 4 or 5 hours of sleep last night. Last night was a really bad night of sleep. So needed to get a little extra caffeine before we hit legs this morning. But now that we got that, we are locked and loaded and good to go. You can probably hear just so much fucking snow here, man. Like, it's wearing gloves and everything. You know, it's just, it's freezing cold. Lots of snow right now. I would turn my dome light on, but I kind of don't want to. Honestly, I kind of feel like this is this a relaxing lighting background? Is this like chill? So I actually have a topic to talk about on the way to the gym today. Typically, I just kind of talk about the training because that's all that I can think about. I'll just kind of get that out of the way real quick. Today's lower B, hardest training session of the week. I will do stiff legs, stiff leg deadlifts, and leg press today. Sleep. So I will get a lot of questions on social media, and I'll get questions from clients as well about whether or not they should train on a bad night of sleep. You know, hey, I got 4 or 5 hours of sleep last night, should I train? And what better time to talk about that than on a day where I got probably 4 to 5 hours of sleep and am going to go train? My answer to that question is yes. And my answer to this question was not yes before I prepped. And I guess I should preface what I'm about to say with this. What I'm about to say really applies the most to competitors. The reality of the situation is that in prep, there is going to come a time where your sleep gets really bad. And, you know, I don't want to say that that's not guaranteed, or I guess say that that is guaranteed, but guys, anyone who's competed or talk to anybody who's competed, if you hear somebody say, I got good sleep this whole prep, that is like a 1 in a fucking 1,000. Like, that never happens. So statistically, and you know, realistically thinking, there is going to come a time in your prep when your sleep gets bad, and it gets bad every day, and there's nothing that you can fucking do about it. And in that situation, you need to train. Like, you're in prep, you need to push through it, and you need to train through it. And I think that's a skill that you can build in your off season, so to say. I think it's a habit that you establish out of discipline. And again, I don't want to get like too carried away with the whole discipline thing. But it comes down to that. Like, you're scheduled to train, and then you get it done because that's just what you do. Now, I also kind of want to caveat that by saying that, like, listening to your body is very important. So if I woke up this morning and I felt absolutely horrible on 4 or 5 hours of sleep, I may not have be going to the gym right now. But I feel fine. Another thing here is mentality. I think that there is a big perspective change that needs to happen mentally. It's very common that I'll hear people say, like, you know, I only got 4 or 5 hours of sleep last night, so I'm not gonna have a bad workout today. And all that I'll say on that is that if you tell yourself that you're gonna have a bad workout today, you're probably gonna have a bad workout today. And if you're somebody who's checking all your variables, and you're nailing your nutrition, you're nailing your hydration, you're managing your stress, you're controlling all of the things that you need to control in order to be in control of your recovery. If one of those things slips up a little bit, in this instance, sleep, I do believe that if you have those other boxes ticked, that they are often strong enough to overcome that. And that is the reality of the situation. I have had a lot of my best training sessions ever on nights of poor sleep. So just because you get poor sleep doesn't mean that you're fucked. What are some things that you can do about it? First would be caffeine. That one's kind of pretty straightforward. I typically take about 150 to 200 milligrams of caffeine before a workout, and today I'm taking 300, and I'll really only use energy drinks like this or pre-workouts and stuff like this on days where I'm really, really dragging. So just I save those for days like this. Another thing that you could do is if you go into the gym and you realize that you're not going to be like on track for numbers or anything, you can always switch the workout to a deload session. Just kind of call an audible and switch it to a deload session. And that may happen today. I may go in the gym and realize, oh my God, I have like no energy and I'm just going to do a deload session today. And then what you could also do, and this could very likely happen, is you could go into the gym and you could realize, oh man, I don't have it today. And you could just take the L and accept that as a loss and go home. And then have today be an improvised rest day, and then come back and do the workout tomorrow. And that was something that Dorian Yates used to do all the time. Let's say Dorian would go in and do his chest day or whatever, and if his first movement of the day was not feeling good or not progressing the way that he wanted it to, he would just go home and then come back the next day and try the workout again. And so if I go in and I do this workout today and it doesn't, I'll give some examples here. So let's say I go in and my first exercise is the adductor, and I think I'm doing like 160 pounds on the adductor today, and I'm going to try and hit that for like 18 reps or something ridiculous like that. Last week I got 16. Let's say I get like fucking 8 today, like it's way off. That would be a very, very obvious sign to me that I don't have it today and I should probably go home. And then I would just go home and make today an improvised rest day, and then come back tomorrow and then do the same workout again. And I've brought that up to people, and I've posted that on social media before, and I've gotten a lot of negative response to that remark. Look, I understand if you got to drive like 45 minutes or something out of the way to go to the gym, but a lot of times when I say that to somebody, a very common response that I will get, people will say, I'm not going to go to the gym just to potentially turn around and go home within 15 to 20 minutes. That's a waste of my time. Look, man, if it's a waste of your time, then it's a waste of your time. But this is very important to me, so I would not consider that a waste of my time. In that instance, I take mental solace. Like, I feel good in the fact knowing that I tried. Like, I didn't give up on myself. I didn't say, oh, I'm gonna have a bad workout today, so I'm just not gonna do it. I said, look, I may have a bad workout today, but I'm gonna fucking give it my all and try to beat my numbers anyways. And if it just isn't happening for me on that day, then I can accept that. But the one thing that I don't accept and won't feel good about is giving up on myself and telling myself that I'm gonna have a bad workout before I actually have it. So that is perfect timing for me to finish my rant, because I am pulling into the parking lot right now, and this workout is gonna get fucked up today despite the fact that I've only gotten 4 to 5 hours of sleep. It doesn't matter. I have done everything that I need to do otherwise in order to nail my variables. Haven't missed a meal, haven't under ate in literally fucking years. Hydration's been fine, stress is fine, I'm properly hydrated, I'm properly caffeinated. These weights are fucked.
Thank you.
Did I say, man, today was perfect. Picture perfect. Picture fucking perfect. Kicked the shit out of everything. Absolutely everything got smoked. I did some stuff on the leg press that I typically wouldn't do, but I had my good friend Joe was in the gym today, and he's been spotting me for years, and he's a perfect spotter, beautiful spotter. So I felt safe and confident to do some low rep heavyweight stuff on the leg press today. Stiff leg deadlifts went up in weight and reps. Leg press went up in weight considerably, and then I hit 8 plates for the first time just to kind of feel what that feels like. And I only expected to get 1 or 2, but I hit it for a triple. I don't want to go exercise by exercise, but every single thing progressed just like I knew what it would. And I kind of want to loop this back to my pre-workout rant. And it's so common for me to have people kind of say things like, you know, you shouldn't train on poor sleep and all of that type of stuff. And I just realistically think that we should stop thinking that we're such fragile little, like, flowers, you know what I mean? Like, our bodies are really fucking resilient, man. And I learned during prep that I'm a tough son of a bitch, man. Like, I can have the cards stacked against me, so to say, like, in terms of sleep and all of that stuff, and I can still come in here and I can still kick the shit out of my workouts every time. And prep taught me that, because as I said at the beginning, when you're in prep, man, you don't have a choice. Like, you're gonna be tired and you're gonna feel like fucking shit, but you still gotta go to the gym, you still gotta progress your lifts, you still gotta
got to get your food in, you still got to get your steps in, and doing a bodybuilding show will teach you whether or not you actually like doing this or not, because this isn't always going to be great. You're not always going to have 8 hours of sleep and be properly fed and hydrated and all of that type of stuff and have all of the stars aligned to come in here and have good training sessions, but you got to be able to get good training sessions in regardless of the fucking circumstances. So I feel like a lot of times when people wake up or whatever, and maybe they get a poor night of sleep and they're headed in the gym, they're thinking, like I said at the beginning, they've already kind of mentally defeated themselves before they even go in the gym. They think, I'm not going to be as strong today because I didn't get much sleep. And they almost like talk down about themselves. And I try not to do that at all. I try to talk myself up. I try to empower myself. I'm a badass motherfucker, man. Like I can progress these lifts, whether I get 5 hours of sleep or whether I get 8, because I tick all of my other boxes, and when I come in the gym, it just fucking happens. Like it's not something that I have to second guess or doubt my abilities in. I am good as fuck at this, and my prep taught me that. So I hope that there's something that some of you guys could take from that. I feel like I'm just kind of ranting at this point, but I feel like a lot of it starts in here. And yeah, like you may not have gotten the best night of sleep last night or whatever, but that doesn't mean that you're just automatically gonna have a shit workout, and that doesn't mean that you're automatically gonna not progress your lifts or anything like that. Like if you decide that you're not gonna progress your lifts, you're probably not going to progress your lifts. If you decide that you're a badass motherfucker and it doesn't matter and you're going to go in the gym and kick the shit out of the weights anyways, that's what's going to happen. So it's a decision that you make, and it really is that simple at the end of the day, in my opinion. One of the pros of doing these super early morning weekend sessions is that it's like 9:30 in the morning right now, man. Like I got the rest of my day to do whatever I want. I'm gonna go home and take a nap because I'm obviously pretty tired and I didn't sleep that well last night. And by the time I get home and take a shower and kind of relax and sit down, it's gonna hit me like a fucking brick wall. So I'll probably take a nap. Carissa and I are gonna go out on a little date night tonight. We're gonna go to Benihana, I think, and get some, you know, the stir fry shit that they do there. Man, the last couple times that I've gone to those like Benihana places, man, I feel like I leave and they didn't fucking give me anything to eat. So if we go tonight and I don't get a ton of food, then I'm gonna be pissed. We'll probably go to Crumble after, because the Crumble cookie menu this week looks pretty decent. Last week the menu was mid. It was so fucking mid. But the week before that was crazy. That was the first time ever that we have gotten all 6 cookies in the Crumble cookie lineup. But this week we'll probably get like 3 or 4 of them. And yeah. That's what's going on for me for the rest of the day. We got playoff football on today. Let's see, at 3:30 we have the Ravens and the... Shit, who do they play? I don't even remember who the Ravens play, but I think the Ravens are a lock for that game. I'm really blanking on who they play right now, but whoever they play, I think it's a lock that they're going to win that one. And then Green Bay and San Francisco later. That game is up in the air, man. Like, I'm a Bears fan, so I fucking hate the Packers, but they have come alive in the postseason here, and they look pretty decent. San Francisco was really fucking good, though, so I feel like that game is up in the air. I'm really blanking with who Baltimore plays. Do they play Houston? I think Baltimore plays Houston. Yeah, because tomorrow is Chiefs and Bills, and then Buccaneers and Lions. Yep, so we got an ambulance coming. Sorry guys, ambulance was just going through. The Ravens play Houston, and I think that game is a lock. But tonight's game should be pretty good, man. That one's up in the air. Chiefs Bills are up in the air, and honestly, the Bucks and Lions are up in the air. I'm rooting for the Lions, man. Obviously, as a Bears fan, they're rivals of us in the NFC North, but they have a good fucking story, man. Dan Campbell has really kind of turned that program around, so kind of rooting for the Lions. But realistically, the Bucks are playing pretty good too, so that game is also up in the air. We got some good playoff football, baby. Pretty excited for that. Pretty decent way to spend the Saturday. Should be a pretty decent day today. Football this afternoon, and then a date night tonight. So really looking forward to the rest of the day, but I got to get a nap in first. pulling into the parking lot here shortly, so I'll just kind of let you guys go. Thanks again for tuning in and following along with me for today's workout. Remember, you guys are not fucking fragile. You guys are strong as fuck. Like, stop convincing yourself that you're gonna have a bad workout just because not everything is perfect. Like, it's very rarely gonna be perfect. And especially in prep, if you're watching this and you wanna be a competitor one day, I hate to fucking break it to you, man, but the reality of the situation is that a good chunk of your prep, you know, I don't wanna say a good chunk, but the latter stages of your prep, pretty much every workout, you're gonna have everything stacked against you, and you're just gonna have to fucking pull it out of your ass, and you're gonna have to make it happen. So you better start finding ways to practice that in your off season. So time to shower, time to eat, time to take a nap. Talk to you guys in a little bit. Rest day tomorrow. Thank you, God. Probably run some errands and get some groceries and stuff in the morning. Take some progress pictures, maybe do a little cardio. We'll kind of see how that goes. But other than that, I'll let you go. Thanks for tuning in, guys. Take care of yourselves as always.